Poetry Festival.
That I know is that there were two forts on this island in the 1790s. One was Fort Jay, and it was a protection on the Hudson for who was coming down the Hudson to attack the settlers.
I was a trainer. for a force that targets and over-polices its black and poor
citizens. Everything in NYC for fabulous smart women soon attracted fabulous smart women from coast to coast and even across the pond. It wasn't just NYC women who were feeling invisible, and I think we could all probably relate to that. The Three Tomatoes newsletter, which talked about everything from where to get the best facials, thong underwear that was actually comfortable, opinions about plastic surgery, Botox, children, husbands, friends, and so much more, gained a following. And then people with expertise and knowledge wanted to be part of the adventure, which it sounds like a good adventure. Before you could say hot flash, Three Tomatoes had a website, and it has grown into a full-blown lifestyle guide for fun and smart tomatoes. So please put your hands together for Cheryl Benton, who's gonna kick it off for the Three Tomatoes.
Oh, I wanna thank you for that lovely introduction, but I'm not Cheryl Benton. I'm one of the Three Tomatoes, one of the poets. Carol Ostro. Woo! And because of the Three Tomatoes, that fabulous publisher, we're all here today. Please don't leave. Please come and join us. This is going to be fun, and it's going to be poetry, and we're here to entertain you, and we're thrilled to be part of the Poetry Festival. Woo! There are three of us, and I'm not paid for that. There are three lovely ladies who want your attention today, because we've published our books, and that's not an easy thing to do. But if we did it, believe me, you can do it too. For our very first poetry reading, I want to introduce to you a fabulous woman who's a great friend of mine, Jane Goldman. She was the first, yay, Jane. Jane, yes. Jane is a Renaissance woman. She now pursues and lives her passions, which include painting, sculpting, music, and writing. And she does a fabulous job of it. So please welcome our very dear Jane Goldman, who wrote with no regrets, Getting Older, Face It, Live It, and Love It.
Thank you, Carol. Thank you, everybody, for being here. My book is called With No Regrets, Getting Older, Face It, Live It, Love It. It has three basic themes. One is about our relationship with our friends, our lovers, but mostly with ourselves, and it can really relate to any age, even though, of course, I might be older than most of you here. And it's about how we deal with aging and the lessons we learn along the way of aging. I wrote my book before the pandemic. The pieces I picked for this event are pieces that are relevant to the pandemic. And I have been asked, thank you, Carol. I have been asked if I would change anything. I'll change the mic. If I would change anything, it would be the title, and I'm passionate about it. My book says, Getting Older, Face It, Live It, Love It. I would now write, Embrace It, Live It, Love It, because if the pandemic has taught us anything, and it taught us all a lot, it is the gift of aging is something to be embraced. And to have all the problems we have, thank goodness, those who are suffering with the virus, their problems would pale in comparison, our problems would pale in comparison to theirs. So with that in mind, the first piece I picked is something that deals with the attitude. And it's called, Just Yesterday. Just yesterday, I woke up. I felt young. The sun was out. I had hopes. I had dreams. I had passions. Today I woke up. I felt old. It was raining. I did not look forward to anything. Men's glances did not stir me. A soulful movie did not make me cry. So tomorrow, what do? Tomorrow, I will find the sun, rain or shine. Tomorrow, I will choose to be young. And I picked this piece, and right now I would change it post-pandemic to say, I would choose to be hopeful, to be grateful, and to be very happy, and that I am well.
And if it weren't for Jane, I don't think I would have written my book. But now I want to introduce you to one of the most wonderful women, most talented. Her name is Nicole Freezer Rubens. And this is her book, which is just gorgeous because it's filled not only with her poetry, her heartfelt, wonderful poetry, but also she is an award-winning photographer, and her photography is just as beautiful as the words that she expresses her feelings in her poetry. Nicole is a native New Yorker who, with her husband Doug, where's Doug? Doug has been schlepping all of our stuff. He's been so fabulous. Thanks, Doug. They raised three beautiful daughters. She studied studio art, history, creative writing, and photography, and is following a career in the art world, launched her own boutique interior design firm. Please, let's welcome Nicole Freezer Rubens.
Hello, everyone. Can you hear me? All right. I just want to say I'm just thrilled to be here with all of you on this beautiful island in New York City as the city reopens in all its glory. I'm going to jump to the last poem in the book that happened to be June 14th, 2020, which was the first day of phase two when New York City opened. June 14th, 2020. Poem, I Put You Down. It is time to deal with the regular world again. Thank you for steering me through the tumultuous season that forever transformed my family and me, and preparing me to live with pride in challenge and change. Corona was my early muse. Black Lives Matter has boldly taken over. Out of these collective horrors, creativity has exploded around me and did not spread any germs. Days and months on pause, gestated and birthed countless videos, memes, TikToks, baked goods, signs, chalk drawings, collaborations, essays, songs, art, photos, poetry, and verse. Then the murder of George Floyd brought the boiling point quarantined out onto the streets to react to centuries of lockdown. Wooden boards of flimsy plywood were erected over glass storefronts, both before and after extensive destruction, and still became fresh blank canvases for more loud, explosive, and deeply layered expression. Some of the graffiti is beautiful, painterly, and meaningful, while other is swift and angry, colored with hatred, by fingers pressing as hard as humanly possible on the delicate little spray buttons. Words and mantras bleed from the lampposts and building cornices. Volume has been given to the voiceless. Our city streets look and sound completely different than they did just recently, when pristine Christmas displays waited for snow cover that did not fall this year. The tune of the holiday carol has been replaced by helicopters that circle and circle above us, and pockets of people chanting in unison. After arcs and floods and fire and brimstone, renewal and purpose must rise from the ashes and urban grit, and in due time, the newest normal will have to be a better normal. It is time to stop the long pause, hit the play button, and inhale deeply so that everyone can breathe equally at last.
Thank you, Nicole. We had a little competition, but your words are magnificent. And thank you also, Jane. And now, tis my time. And I've written a book, Poems from My Pandemic Pen by Carol Ostro. And I think I'll start off a little differently with something that you can all identify with. Guilt is a waste of time. In this day of the corona disease, I consume comfort food, if you please. What saves my life, definitely not dietish, is a bagel, tomato, and fresh tuna fish. Oozing cheese on buttered bread does more for me than going to bed. That's a little confession. This reaction sure does play with my head. Well, I hate the thought of what calories will do, but now, who cares? I'm not feeling blue. Martha's cookies, called kitchen sink,
put me in a mood you would call pretty pink. Thank you. Raisins and almonds and brown sugar now is so much better than the average of Dow. My hind quarters are about to grow in size, but wearing pajamas, I do realize that 2020, in my hindsight, will be the time of terrible fright. But, oh my Lord, I put up a fight. Never forget that weight can be lost, but mental health is worth the cost. Bring on the cake with buttercream frost. Does this entice? Well, perhaps you'll share a slice. Makes me hungry every time. And to end, you've all been such a wonderful, attentive audience to all of us. And I also want to thank Janine Pierce Doswell for being our videographer today. All of you are going to be part of it. Thank you, Janine. This is called Keep On Going. I'm feeling sad. Is it all in my head? Why, in fact, should I get out of bed? To live every single moment, you daydreaming idiot. I wish you, our audience, endless tomorrows. Thank you for listening to us. We love being here. You're wonderful. See you next year, ladies.
Please don't be the end.
Love.